no grass today, but that's 'cause I'm the one on stage. So who am I to take away what makes you feel this great? I didn't smoke no grass today, but that's because I love to play. So who am I to take away what makes you feel this great? Does the grass look greener on my side of the speakers?
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and every gender in between, to your fun-loving, free-flying 420 episode. We are live at Stonerway recording this amazing episode. I know we are live, but we are recording.
Are we?
We are somewhat live.
Recording
your favorite smoke sesh, 42 Strains. I am one of your hosts, Surfer Dan. To my left is the beautiful, amazing Rue.
Ooh, hello.
To her left is the sleepy Butts.
Hello.
Butts has not been on the show. Butts, what is it?
Abbreviation?
What is it with the acronym?
Oh, an acronym.
Thank you, acronym. I'm very high. We pre-gamed hard, ladies and gentlemen. To Butt's left is the beautiful Peaches.
Hello, everyone.
Aww.
To her left is the amazing Snacks.
Hi, guys.
To her left is the not quite as plain as sometimes he sounds, Salt.
Hola.
Oh, spicy.
Yes.
All the way across the room from him is one of my partners in crime, Buddy Christ himself. Double A, how the hell are you?
Doing pretty good, man. Pretty stony fucking baloney right now, honestly.
It's a pretty good 420,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, pretty good 420 so far,
you know, somewhere across the country or whatever, there's probably a listener thinking that we're alluding to Kevin Smith possibly being on this podcast.
Yes, that's what we're trying to say. We're trying to say that. And to his left is the one and only Chuck Dante. Chuck.
Well, hello, hello, hello.
Oh, I always love you when you say hello to everybody.
I think everybody loves
Spam, we decided to get together for this special 420 episode. Rather than doing a review, we figured it'd be fun to just fucking get together and see exactly how blazed we can get. And that's why some of us are dozing off and some of us need a coffee to continue with life.
Because they're fucking old.
Because they're fucking old. I'm 419 years old.
I feel personally attacked.
I didn't say I mean, needed it.
You are.
I just rather have it.
You guys should feel attacked.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm attacking, so I'm fine.
You're old.
We have what?
Equality.
We have, we've done dabs.
Yes.
We have a time bomb ready to go.
We do.
We have another bowl ready to go.
We have a sleepy puppy.
We have a sleepy puppy.
She's a puddle.
And we have some weird philosophical questions, and we have some odd, wacky news. let's get those bowls ready to go.
Absolutely.
And I say we kick off with some wacky news.
Right on.
Yeah.
Spark this one up over with
a song. Yeah.
Man sees Captain Marvel 116 times to break Guinness record.
Awesome. Ooh.
116.
Did he ever did he see it all on
yeah, was it
the same day?
No, that's more than a day.
I mean, I know, but I'm saying,
was it consecutively?
A little bit more than a day.
It consecutively?
No, I don't believe so.
Wasn't good enough.
I'm sure it had to be close because, you know, it's only in theaters so long. It doesn't, the article itself just says that he's from Wisconsin.
Of course
it's his. It's his fifth world record that he's broken. Wait till you hear.
Nothing else to do.
Wait till you hear the other ones. They're great.
Tiny dick.
His name is Steve Rappel of Weston.
Again, I felt
that. He spent 12,268 minutes watching the latest Marvel Cinematic Universe film.
And for anyone who doesn't know, that is I don't know how many hours.
He thought it was impossible.
that he prevailed.
He said, to be official, I have to take certain pictures taken. Like in front. Oh, fucking time bomb's getting lit right now.
Oh.
Just hotness.
Salt, you can light up as well if you'd like. So we're mixing it up this episode.
We are. We're all over the place.
We are.
We're it's 420.
It's because there's no structure.
He needs,
no structure.
He needs to
Stop dying, Sean.
He needs two written witness statements saying that he was actually there.
Okay.
One of them was Brie Larson.
Did he take any bathroom breaks?
No.
No.
He just peed on the floor like everyone else does.
So, Rappel has four previous Guinness records to his name, including running half a marathon while wearing the most number of shirts. Oh, no reaction to that
well,
one,
that's
guys.
Just lazy.
Say how many.
Why did I do the whole thing?
How many? I believe we looked
Sorry,
it up and it
was
33 was the last time he ran a marathon with a bunch of shirts.
But don't hold on. I can understand why he picked shirts over pants. All right, that makes sense.
Well, it's impossible to run after a certain
All
amount
I'm
of pants.
All I'm going to say is he's a bitch.
Wow.
But, such hostility towards
Why of all... why did he come up with this? Why did that one, of all of them that he could
the
have done?
The shirts one with the marathon thing?
Yeah.
Because he can?
It's one that he could break.
There's not a lot
Do you
of people
want,
doing it.
Another one they mention is he is the... He has the fastest...
No one else has done.
He has the fastest time to drink 1 liter of gravy.
I hate that.
Oh.
Ew.
I really hate that.
Do you want, oh, it was through a straw.
It was
That
makes
it worse.
Yeah,
that makes
it
worse.
Was it from KFC?
No, it was actually, it looked
like
homemade gravy.
I could beat that.
I could just drink that.
You want to know how long it took him? Only 1 minute and 12 and a half seconds.
For a liter?
For a whole liter of gravy.
I could do two in that time.
I'm concerned about his
bowels. Dude, I don't know. It's a lot of gravy, dude.
Why? Why? Why did you...
Or Popeye's gravy?
Through a straw?
Yeah.
I'm so confused. Why are you concerned about
his
bowels?
I could chug it.
Everything right now is perfectly so greased.
I think part of the record is that
he could pass a fucking Buick.
Hey, I have
one. Only if Guinness says it's okay.
Jesus.
It could pass through his bowels.
Did we intro our song yet?
Oh, shit, I didn't even say the song before we went into Wacky News. That's how high I am.
Good
how
fucking job.
Sorry, I just
The song they
that.
Heard, like, 15 minutes ago by now. I don't even know. That was No Grass Today by AJR.
I love them.
A group that... ends up being played quite often in our smoke sessions.
It does, yeah.
They got good music to just listen to, and, like, you know, some of the songs are better than others, and I actually don't like some of them, just to be honest. But, I mean, like, it's great
them
background
and
music.
And Half Alive is another group that shows
Half
up Alive quite often.
I'll play you.
They have a mashup.
They do. I need to watch that still.
Yes.
It's good.
Because there are two different groups that have made videos that are kind of, like, similar in style and use the same, like...
You mean in the urban bat cave whenever Wayne Manor got destroyed?
Yeah, basically.
They're using, like,
That's the
same,
set.
And they used it, and I love
it's
it.
It's great. They got a cool
blender
going there.
Yeah. Surfer Dan.
So, drinking gravy. Would you? Have you ever thought about breaking a world record? Were you one of those kids? I just want to know.
I thought about it.
And?
I just didn't see anything that I could do that would be. Even when I thought of something that I was like, you know, I could make that record because that nobody's made it yet.
Yeah.
It wasn't good enough for me. I was
Nothing
like,
was
I'd rather enough. Beat a record.
Anybody else? Anybody else ever think of I'm gonna try this?
Although every time I looked at the hot dog eating record, I was like, never.
I'm pretty sure I have one. It was for most time masturbated in a single day.
No, I'm gonna fight you on that one.
There is some people
all
in
right,
this room.
All right, a reporter, someone did it 78 times and died.
What?
Whoa.
Jerked off 77 times and died.
77? Ooh.
Yeah.
And died? From, like, what, overexertion?
Probably, or just lack of fluids.
Damn.
with that woman who drank a gallon of water.
Dehydration would
died.
Probably be it. That would probably be the one, right?
You gotta hydrate before you do any kind of extreme sports.
During.
One hand.
A banana. Drink some Gatorade.
There you go.
Lots of water.
There you go. I thought about it. I used to love the Guinness Book of World Records as a kid. That was something that we still got it in print. And I loved going through it and seeing all the weird, wacky things. And The only thing that it always grossed me out, I don't know why, the whoever won the that year for the Guinness Book of World Records for the longest fingernails.
Oh, God.
That
yeah.
shit always grossed me out.
Toenails, too.
Toenails?
Yeah, oh. See, oh, thankfully okay. mine Super usually
Dan,
didn't
let's
have
get that.
That
straight. You said it was in print. It was in chisel etching on tablets.
That's true. The very first Guinness Book of World Records was 100% chiseled. On a granite tablet outside
and
my house.
That's when the world record for living was 14 years.
Yep. And now
I
beat it.
And you held it.
Yep. I'm still beating it.
Woo. So strong.
Had a baby.
419 years strong. So I've been pondering these weird questions lately while super high.
Right on.
I'm sure everybody does this kind of shit.
No, never.
Ever?
No.
Oh, okay. No, well, then never mind. I won't even bring it up then.
No, I'm just...
you no, it's fine.
You think we do
it. Do it.
I do quite often.
I need a lighter.
Un fuego.
I can't find
that
one.
That sounds like your personal
Thank you.
Problem.
It
yeah,
is
that
a
sounds,
personal problem,
that sounds
but
like
I'm asking
a,
for help.
That sounds like a root problem.
Ooh, it is a root problem.
And one of them that I had was, so if you had the opportunity, there's a time travel for space group out there, and they've got it all situated where you can now go back in time or forward in time, wherever you want to go, and spend 48 hours there, and they paradox free it by putting you in a time loop. So whatever you do in that 48 hours does not matter. You can't change anything because it's going to go right back to being exactly how it was before you showed up. Where would you go? What would be your 48 hours?
Ooh,
ooh, ooh.
I would want to go back to, so I'd want like 24 hours of the dinosaurs, and then I'd want to see the massive meteor shower that like set off their extinction.
So you want to see the last 24 hours of the dinosaurs of that period.
Yeah, see everything real nice and happy and pretty, see what it looks like, check it out.
All
and
the big dinosaurs
awesome crazy.
And watch
yeah,
it completely get
shower,
wiped out
wow.
destroyed.
Yeah.
Holy
okay.
fuck.
That'd be crazy to do.
Yeah.
Dang it, now I want to go back and watch like Pangea spread apart.
Ooh!
Wow.
We only have 24 hours.
That's going to be, yeah,
that's
48.
That's
48.
Yeah,
48 hours. 48.
48. Sorry, 48.
Okay, then I'm going to stick to my original. I want to go back to Inauguration Day and shoot President Trump in the head over and over and over again.
Just
for
your
48
own.
Hours.
Yeah,
just, yeah.
We have 42 strains. Do not advocate violence against anybody else.
Where are you?
So yeah, I actually want to jump forward.
Okay.
I don't want to go back. I want to jump forward.
48 hours in?
Whenever it is, I'm going to...
That narrows down the dial?
Just type in whatever it is.
Whatever it is.
The doctor will find it.
Thank you, doctor.
Greater than now, but less than before.
To be able to explore more of the ocean. The deeper ocean. And, what is it? The trench.
Mariana Trench.
Okay, so like the time period when we've invented some type of commercial vehicle that you could just take and go down there itself.
Yeah. Okay.
Wonderful. Anybody else have a type of vehicle?
The one that comes to mind first for me, I don't know why, probably because I'm high, I instantly went to the planning, execution, and day after of the Boston Tea Party. I feel like that'd be a fun one to join in on that.
That would be cool.
Just a giant fuck you to the man.
You find out it's like super lackadaisical. Like it was actually super.
They were just drunk
and they're just like
planning it now,
pushing boxes over. You're like, guys, really? We're trying to start a revolution. What is going on?
And they're just like, oh, box. Okay, we're good. Let's go home.
But the empowerment.
You want us to pay for your tea, right?
But the empowerment you would feel in that moment, though.
I gotcha. I'm pretty sure history probably rewrote it funny. It was probably that they were all just drunk. So like an hour before they did it, they're like, no, I dare you to do it.
You're not
going to
do it. I'm
going to
do it.
Fuck them. Let's do it. Hold on, somebody's gonna see it's us. Put feathers on your head. It'll be fine, nobody ever. Don't wear your powder wig, just put feathers on your head, it'll be fine.
I got cool. happy fun ones.
Cool.
Where would you go?
I would go to the grand opening of Disneyland Resort.
Wow.
The very first opening day.
Wow.
With everything in full launch. And Coney Island as well. The launching day for Coney Island. For the period.
Well, you got to pick one because you only got 48 hours in one spot.
In one spot?
That's Disney. The time loop. Disney. One spot.
48 hours in Disney.
All right. All right. Double A, did you have a spot? I'm super high. Did you answer?
I don't believe so.
I did not.
Okay. Do you have a spot at all? Since you're double fisting it there? Ladies and gentlemen, double bongs. Double bongs.
It's a weird one, but I would go approximately like 15 billion years into the future and watch the sun die.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm kind of that high right now.
Wow.
Okay.
Welcome to 420. Wow.
That's fucking impressive.
It's just, you know, to be like, you know, at our distance from our sun, there would be about, I think I read like something like a couple of hours or almost like a day where you would actually see the sun die.
Wow.
You would, like, witness the beginning of a supernova.
I don't think that would happen, though, because we're only 9 light minutes away from the sun.
Yeah, it's like, I can't remember what I read about it when they
you're
put
right,
the time
you're
table.
High enough,
you're
have
high.
Time to
yeah, it's fine.
Though.
You know what I mean?
I got you.
It's, you know, you'd see something.
Yeah,
you know,
see something.
For whatever amount of time it is.
I think we can make this work. We can make it work.
Whatever amount of time it is, yeah, I'd want to see it.
All right. Yeah. Salt, did you answer?
Actually, kind of going off of,
Double A's answer.
I want to see a supermassive supernova. Just because those are supposed to be the biggest.
Like a champagne supernova?
Light shows.
Where were you while we were getting high? Sorry.
Those are just have the biggest light shows. I don't know, that'd be crazy. Or the Big Bang.
The Big Bang.
The Big Bang, just to see it all start.
Okay, wait. But you got 48 hours, so where are you starting?
Probably like 30 minutes or so before.
What the fuck?
So, 30 minutes
he's
complete
prep.
Nothingness.
Oh, yeah.
30 minutes of just you floating
you
complete
just want to
nothingness.
Tease yourself. You know it's coming.
Wait, but could you be
exactly.
floating when there's nothing to float in?
That's you'd be.
Technically, in this hypothetical situation, yes, you could, because, like. You
I'm
going to
assume.
I mean, you're already
okay.
existing.
There is
outside
no gravity,
space,
there is no standing.
Yeah.
There is no nothing. You are
already,
very much like in utero.
Consciousness is floating as a, I don't know.
We find out you just
want to
watch the Earth
I'm
get made and tell everyone it's not
sci-fi.
Flat.
That'll be nice.
No, you really find out
are
that right
sure?
before the Big Bang, there's actually specifically one lawn chair sitting outside of where it's about to happen for the one person who gets to watch.
No, but it says reserved,
and it's salt.
As he gets closer,
and
it,
yeah,
says
it's salt.
His name. It says his name on it.
Floats into
yeah,
it.
Like,
all right,
you're
ready.
Watching like this giant like explosion or whatever that created stuff. Like, can you take damage? Can't you die from that? What do you
I, in the time loop scenario for this paradox free, you can't take damage because you need to go back. You can't. You're basically immortal inside that time loop,
oh,
because
yeah.
you have to be sent back to you, where you were before you enter the time loop. Just like the time loop has to exist on its own outside the main continuum, so nothing can be changed in there. So you're just observing it. It's going to go right back to being exactly how you observed it, no matter what you do to try and change it.
Plus, for half an hour, he's floating in space that doesn't exist yet. So
yeah.
really, I
what
think we can
just...
What
are you going to do for that half hour?
He's
going to jack off.
So beat the record!
Why is everybody
going
to jack off?
Are you telling me... Hold on, are you telling me that for 30 minutes floating completely in nothingness, sensory deprivation, knowing that the Big Bang is about to happen,
hot.
Knowing you've got 30 minutes, you're not going to try and time that shit?
Or
you're not
going to
sit there and go,
what if you call your nut the Big Bang?
Well,
just
slowly
oh my god,
started.
That's how the universe started. It was Wesley.
Wow.
That's how it started. Salt. Salt did it. He salt shookered all over the universe.
Shookered.
Oh
we've
salt
made
shaker.
Such a scientifical phenomenon.
What's the past tense of shaker?
Shooken.
Shooken. He salt shooken. all over the... That doesn't shake sound any
no,
better.
Well, because you're turning it into, like, shook, an adverb.
Shook. You're right. Shook. I'm trying to change its exact...
You're trying to change its grammatical...
English
like,
majors, I apologize if I just blew your mind there.
I don't think
oh,
you
I'm supposed to
light.
Light this. You this should. Is mine. Can you hand me that lighter right there? I literally can't lean further than this.
No.
But now, I think the next question, if he's giving himself 30 minutes, what is Salt's refractory period? Can he go round two before it happens?
No, you just
are
slow
you
jack
serious?
It.
Totally.
Slow jack, 29 minutes.
I could totally do it a second time.
Yes! We got some flavors.
Like, I'm just thinking question. Of the whitest kid you know sketch, slow jerk.
Although I would do it just the once, just because you know, the second time's never really.
You gotta time it right. A, yeah.
You slow jack it for 29 minutes.
And then powerhouse is that
three.
Scream
two,
at it, call your bitch.
One. Happy
you
know, universe.
You basically literally get to fuck the entire universe for a second.
All of it. All of it. For an instant.
I think it'd be amazing if you actually happened to bust right in the direction of the Big Bang. So it gets on a little bit of it all.
I think that would
expands.
Be amazing.
You would create aliens.
And
wow.
us.
I, yeah, what if
that's
I
how
created
Earth
life.
Was created.
I seeded
like
life throughout the galaxy.
Thank you, Father.
Because of this
then we just
you're
call it
welcome.
Salt in the wound.
You could say salt has been inside all of us.
I am, well, we could almost say that anyway.
man.
I'm leaning more to I'm maybe I'm selfish or maybe it's my old age. I'm leaning more towards with Chuck seeing something super happy fun times. I think I'd like 2 days at Woodstock. I think
the
OG Woodstock.
Beware of unicorns.
Yeah, I should be aware of unicorns, right? But the problem is with 48 hours. It's 3 day festival. I gotta pick which two.
Yeah.
Now
you
it did
out.
End.
Second day.
It's
the end.
Now technically it did begin midway through a day and end midway through a day. So I think that is 48 hours. It just was over 3 days.
I just know the getting there and the leaving there are the parts that sucked.
No, I'm just gonna jump right in there.
That's what I'm saying. So jump
yeah.
in there.
No yeah. traffic.
Absorb it
right.
while
yeah.
you're there.
So that's what I would do. Nail a bunch of hippie chicks. Because nothing that I do will change anything. It'll just
yeah.
time loop right back. So I'll nail a few. Just jump into an orgy.
You go find Janice.
I would find Janice and oh, the things I would do.
Two Joplin.
I would make the worst Dr. Seuss book. Oh, the things I would do to Janice Joplin.
That
was the original. Yeah, no, that's
wow.
that was the worst. That was the worst hit of my life.
So
God.
Sorry. But yeah, that's what I would do. I was gonna Woodstock. I would see something so iconic live in person.
That'd be yeah.
That's
pretty
me.
Cool. I love that they're doing a 50th anniversary of Woodstock this year. I think that's amazing.
Yeah, after they failed at one. And a half.
I think you're amazing.
Girl, you're amazing. Just the way you... Sorry. Song cue. It was a song cue. hey, Double A, you got more wacky news?
I really do, though.
You really do, though?
It actually kind of has to almost do with the last one because it's another record.
Oh!
A Canadian company breaks Guinness record for high fives.
That's so Canadian.
What?
Wow.
A Canadian.
How many?
A Canadian company said employees unofficially, even though it is official, there's like videos and like, you know what I mean? I think they're probably just waiting for it to be confirmed or whatever. Broke a Guinness World Record by completing 509 high fives in 3 minutes.
I think we can beat that guy.
No, you have to see.
Canada's going to beat us.
It literally. It literally took
33
employees, and they spent months practicing at their record.
33? What if we just get more numbers?
Yes, because they had to figure out a technique to get the most high fives.
What if we just increase the numbers?
Right.
What if we invite all of our spam
sure, but then I
to
think
write
like,
us at 42strains@toke.com and see if they want to high five with us?
Oh, no.
Hashtag
we'll, Team America.
But it's really high five.
Wow.
Here to save the motherfucking day.
42 strains, really high
fuck
five.
Yeah.
Hashtag really high five.
See, but then I think you enter a new record. Like, I'm pretty sure that Guinness is going to be like, most high fives done by 33 people in 3 minutes.
I think ours would be most high fives done while under the influence of marijuana.
In 3 minutes?
In 3 minutes. I think five would do that record. I think we're going to be okay.
That's pretty amazing. Back with a strong vengeance.
But I mean,
it's not going to smoke pot just to get
if
back
you wanted, I mean, if you want to have them, go ahead and write us in at 42strains@toke.com. That's one thing.
That's one thing.
But if they wanted to happen to reach us at our Twitter account,
why are you doing this,
Surfer Dan?
This isn't funny.
Now I picture you like
nobody finds this funny.
How do you think they might be able to get a hold of us?
This is tedious. I heard Peaches chuckling over there.
Nobody finds this funny.
How can they get a hold of us, Surfer Dan?
Fine, they can find all of us over on the Twitter at the Twatterboos. They can find you, Chuck Dante, at iHeartChuckabee. They can find AA at AA1242. I almost fucked that up. Find Salt nowhere. He stays away from it because he doesn't like the drama.
He's salty.
He's afraid of pepper finding.
You can find Snacks at SnackQueen21. You can find Peaches at Squeaky_Peach. You can find Butts at iHeartBigButts, and I can lie.
That's not on Twitter, dude. That is not
a 42 Strains
Twitter.
And you can find Rue at Blazing Roots. You can also find me at Surfer Dad. Just kidding. He's still pooping. You can find me at the number 42.
You actually can search Surfer Dan, and he will show up first. If you search Surfer Dan on Twitter. Yeah, absolutely.
Wow, I'm impressed. I must be more active than the others.
But he's still pooping.
Maybe, well, because he had a lot of bran. And he's been on all
no
brand
diet. Starch.
You should be
like 7 years. He's like this. It's this horrible Sisyphusian cycle.
Aluminium.
He's eating and he just keeps shitting.
Siminin.
And he can't. Sisyphus. Yes. Up
Library.
Yes. Thank you. So and every time he gets almost to the top, it rolls back down. He has to go roll it back up, so it's a futile journey. Yes. That's what my story is, and I'm sticking
with it. If you can't tell by the sound, listeners, we're smoking a lot of weed. Just to be 100%.
Several bowls deep, a couple of dabs. We already did a time bomb without you, AA. I apologize for that, but I don't really.
I said nothing.
I know.
No apology.
It's the thought that counts.
But with an apology.
But would you like an apology?
No.
I'm sorry that we smoked time bomb without you, but I'm not at all sorry.
See, did it again.
I don't understand.
To you, I'm very sorry. To our spam and everyone in the room, no, I'm not sorry.
Wow, this is weird.
This
is a weird apology. I don't know if I accept.
Just take it.
I don't want to. I don't want to.
Take it.
That's your choice. This hurt last time.
Are you okay?
Maybe.
Are you fine?
No.
Are you all right?
I'm not sure.
You sure?
He had the worst day of his life a few seconds ago. Give him a chance.
Okay, so a genie.
It was a few minutes ago.
A genie comes down.
Okay.
Ready?
Okay, fucking Rue. Dude, I'll hit you in front of company.
Wow.
Yeah. I believe in equality. Hey, she beats me behind this microphone.
I just got an Audi.
Like with your belly button?
Yes.
Like your belly button that wasn't any turned into an Audi?
Yes.
Let's just say I'm a grower, not a shower.
I heard it.
Ex-wife to Johnny Depp?
Oh, man. We're just going to bring up the herd. You know, I just found out today he actually tried to get her kicked off of Aquaman before it came out.
Damn.
Yeah, but he just didn't have enough. He didn't, you know, just didn't catch it in time. Yeah, they just didn't.
Maybe
catch
if he had
time.
Said yes to one of the 50 million projects they tried to give him, they would have listened to
him. Didn't he say yes to like five of them?
Disney or DC's? No.
Pirates, right? He's in like five of them.
That's no, DC is what I meant.
Oh, DC. No.
Aquaman's
no.
DC.
Yeah.
What roles did they offer him for?
49.
Nightwing.
He's been offered everything.
Nightwing.
Probably, actually. Actually, no, back when he was younger, I thought he was offered Robin.
Oh,
man.
Yeah, I think he was.
Yeah. Oh, that's interesting. That would be a real weird alternate universe.
So a genie arrives. Here's a scenario for
you. I think in a weird way, Marvel, he'd actually make a pretty, interesting, Mr. Fantastic.
No.
Yeah, sorry, Snag Surfer Dan says you're fucking wrong.
I'm just glad
Sorry, your opinion is not a valid thing here.
It's not a safe circle.
Surfers have no opinion.
No.
So Richard Reed, he is not.
No.
So a genie. We broke this.
Oh, so genie arrives.
Nice segue.
Genie arrives and offers you immortality in trade for one of your senses.
Oh, fuck you.
Hearing.
What do you take?
Hearing.
Why?
My sense of pride. That's already gone.
Oh.
The top five senses. You know what I'm talking about.
Fuck. That was a good answer, though.
That is a very good answer. My sense of shame. lost that a long time ago, honey.
Can I
change
lizard.
My top five?
No.
You know what I'm talking... What the fuck? Are you the caramel camel? Because this is the kind of shit he would pull.
Yeah. I mean, to be fair, the genie wasn't specific. But...
Okay, now, in this hypothetical situation, the genie specific, motherfuckers.
Yes.
Get excited.
Taste,
the genie specific now. Now that we want to be like that, the genie's
hearing,
like, no.
Touch. Done. Those five, you have to give up one.
Peach just says here. She don't want to hear no more for immortality.
I mean, I can't hear already anyways.
I know it's great for
just
audio.
Just so y'all know, people, almost all of us are mouth speaking at Peaches right now. Just give her a sense.
Just everybody. That's
man.
What a show would sound like, two Peaches.
If you guys have ever seen Degeneration X, you know what I'm doing.
Anybody else have an answer? What sense would you give up?
Smell.
Smell?
It's the easiest to live without.
It's the easiest one, right?
It's just the easiest one to live without.
I disagree. But you don't lose communication.
Hearing is literally affecting your whole entire perception of the world around you.
Remove my
taste. Smell
does
not do that to you. You can live your life normal without
smell.
Okay.
I know someone who can't smell, and he doesn't have some type of disability. Hearing, you need to read things differently.
I'm going
to
tell you right now. Without a sense of smell, make BART rides a lot easier to evade. I'm just saying.
Yeah. See, there's some benefits.
There's a lot of benefits with that one.
There's
you
want to
lose your
smell.
Sense of taste?
Yes.
With how much you enjoy food?
Yes.
You want to lose your sense of taste?
For immortality. There's no saying what I might have
but
to
not
be
smell.
Really
you're
gonna resolve keep myself.
Smell. So you're
going to
smell the food.
Yeah.
Know what it smells like.
Yeah.
Never be able to taste.
There's
it
things that I actually physically can't eat right
you
now
like
in my
being
life
hit, don't
because
you?
Of the taste. Well, there's certain things that I'm actually not able to enjoy because of the taste.
Okay.
No matter like how good certain people say it is for me.
Yeah.
Things like that, and I think
kale.
I can live like a healthier
sorry,
lifestyle throughout my
kale
immortality.
Yeah, you can eat all the kale you want.
I can eat anything.
Kale is delicious.
And not be inhibited by a
I
weird texture
kale.
Or a taste.
Kale chips are the best.
Then I would
I'm
love
sorry.
That.
You're kind of building
I'm
an
sorry.
Advantage.
It's so good.
Off
you
of,
just take
yeah.
kale
deal.
And you bake
yeah,
it.
So it might, yeah, so it might be
oil
messed up that I love the taste of food, but I enjoy smelling it. I enjoy cooking it. If you know, I can actually specifically lose just taste. It's okay. I think I can still enjoy all the other aspects in there, but I would be able to enjoy a lot more things.
Wow. Meanwhile, in the background conversation, we have the new award for the greatest thing ever said on this show.
What's that?
I love kale. It's delicious.
Oh, that was peaches.
If she had a little chihuahua under her arm and a mocha like a chocolate depot.
Damn it, our chihuahua's gone tonight.
Oh.
Ours is at home.
It's on lease. I'd need bug boots and... Yeah.
Which you
sure
have.
You have those.
I think she has to speak to a manager.
You have green blue hair.
Thank you.
Yes, Karen.
Oh.
Karen.
Do you have more wacky news?
Everybody answered that one?
Maybe. Did everybody? I don't know. I'm high. Anybody
Peach
have a...
picked hearing.
Yeah, hearing.
God,
I heard a bunch of people
sight.
Agree with you with smell because, that's the easiest one to give
would
up.
Would anyone
in my
give up sight?
Give up sight.
I won't even say that it's the easiest one to give up. It's just the least effective on your immediate life.
And it does have the benefits, like you said. Now, what if
traveling to San Francisco?
Let me narrow it down though. What if the genie said, okay, you have to choose between sight or hearing for immortality?
Give up hearing.
Hearing.
Those are the only two: sight or hearing.
Yeah, probably hearing.
Hearing.
Really?
It would absolutely kill me to not be able to hear music
sorry
again.
Sorry
to
many
sight
deaf
just
people
really
who are listening to us
me.
Right now. Also, please get with me and how you're doing this.
We should set up some closed captioning. Right. I'm sure we can find a way. Because we do have...
Melody, I'm going off into the stars and shit. I don't really need to hear most of the things.
There's no sounds.
I won't be able to hear most of the things, so... I want to go see fucking space, but...
Yeah.
So you want to see stuff.
People can't be mad at me for not speaking their language if I can't speak any language.
Can't hear you.
I just wanted to go out.
Yeah. All right.
Whoa. Oh, sorry. Not doing Pussycats right now?
No, I don't think we're doing
I'm sorry.
No, I was telling Keller asking
you
for water.
You would
choose
smell?
I think so.
Okay.
I didn't go, yeah, that's the one I, like, would absolutely want to give up, but, like, I started thinking about what are the other ones that, like, I don't want to lose, like, an aspect of.
Yeah.
I did, worst
priority.
Yeah, you did a pyramid in your head.
Yeah.
You
know. But out of all the senses you use, I think touch is probably not the most prevalent.
Yeah, except for the fact that it is a big safety thing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know when to let go of a pot.
But you're immortal.
It's actually you probably wouldn't be able to walk for a while because couldn't feel anything.
Yeah.
You wouldn't know how to walk. You'd be like, oh my god, I can't feel the pressure.
Okay.
You couldn't feel the pressure of your legs.
I'm sure
like,
there's a lot of people
sure
listeners
some...
of ours that already know.
Sure, yeah. There's probably some like muscle memory, but just the shock of not being
there.
Really,
there are people who live who have that disability, or that disease where they can't feel anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm just saying one day I feel everything, one day I don't, and I can walk perfectly fine. Like, that doesn't happen. You know, you'd have like the shock of that happening to you, and you'd have to go through that like rehabilitation. That would be the thing of losing touch.
Yeah, but you're immortal, so you got a lot of time to figure it out.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it's what you want to trade for mortality. We're all winning in every scenario, really.
Yes.
I don't know. I don't think I'd want to be immortal.
That's not
the
question.
It's a deeper question, though.
Question for another show.
Yeah, that's a deeper question.
I'm just
or the
saying.
Next question, I guess.
Just saying.
But I do have another story.
Ooh, what's another story?
Florida man, 80 years old.
Yes.
Fights an alligator in his backyard and wins.
Oh,
yes.
Florida man.
Oh, he won?
Yeah.
Of course, he's from Florida.
He's Florida man.
He always wins.
Ed
Deep
Chapman.
In the heart of America's wang lives a man.
He tried to.
That was not his first alligator fight.
He tried to capture a 6.5-foot alligator.
Wow.
Oh, there's a video.
Petty and cruel.
Oh, there's a there
was
video.
Video
on the side.
Honestly, I just
his
want to know if they messed up
was
Hercules. An alligator or it was a crocodile.
Hercules.
No, I think like police have confirmed what it is in animal control.
Yeah,
it's confirmed.
Not that smart.
Dude, wow. I think the ones in Florida know the difference between a crocodile and an alligator.
Are you sure?
Yes, I think so. I think they
it's
see enough of them.
It's probably like the only.
If there's
thing
one
know.
Thing they know.
If there's oh,
you have
know
one job.
You know what?
If
when
there's
you put it that
one
way,
thing they
when
know.
When you put it that way,
that's really big scrams.
You know what? You're right. You're right. If
just
one thing.
When
right?
you put it like that, 100%, I'm pretty sure they could tell the difference between an alligator.
What do you think would be the second thing? If
the second thing they would know how to spot a meth lab.
From at least a mile away.
I'm
gonna
say
from
Cuban.
At least a mile.
Cuban
food. Yes. Tasty Cuban
right
food.
Right on. Oh, we got double fisted again.
Oh, I love it when you fist so much.
Wow. Drive-by fisting.
Drive-by fisting.
Jesus.
That is
one,
the goal
two, three,
of this campaign.
Where did this come from? What is happening?
Drive-by. Nothing. Nothing. Nothing at all.
Fisting is happening.
Nothing at all.
What the
fuck?
There's
it's
a
fine.
Whole issue of consent
it's fine.
There, though.
It's fine.
It's
fine. It's fine. Don't worry.
Okay. All right. I trust you.
Some people like surprise, yeah.
Blindly, really.
You should trust us blindly.
So there's a second genie.
Yes, there's another genie comes along and said, I've got a better deal for you.
Okay. Oh, he's got a better deal than the first
better.
Genie.
It's not immortality, I'm sorry for that, but it is a superpower.
What's the superpower?
Okay. I want you to pick what superpower you feel would be most beneficial to your life.
Photographic memory.
What about if you're invulnerable to anything? Then technically you'd be immortal.
No, because that's the ravages of time.
But that if you're
you're still going to age. You may age at a slower rate, like Wolverine, but he still ages.
The superpower to make money appear in my hand whenever the fuck I feel like it. That would honestly assist my life 100% greater right now.
Wow. All right.
Ching. Money.
I would want to teleport.
Teleportation.
Yeah. The ability to have anything I want. Because then if I wanted money, I could have money. If I wanted, like,
diamonds, an airplane?
Or, like, an airplane or, like,
so are you talking, like, Green Lantern where you can manifest shit?
Listen,
or,
no,
like, you can...
No, I think it'd be more like the chance, the girl who has, like, Lady Luck on her side.
Gotcha.
If
gotcha.
If he just fortunate,
like, wills it to me.
Gotcha.
Almost.
Okay. I like that.
I think I'd want to be a speedster.
A speedster?
Yeah.
Get more shit done?
Absolutely. No, just go to El Sobrane. It costs about $30. They hook you up with some good shit.
No.
Sorry, 42 Strains does not condone El Sobrane actions.
No.
Oh,
at
God.
All.
No.
Like, nothing they do there, I think,
no.
we approve of.
I don't know what that is, but I'm curious to know.
Oh, it's a place where they do things.
No.
Oh, I love things.
No,
so
I don't
you're saying
know.
Your superpower, you'd like to run fast.
Fast. Speed.
Okay,
star.
Yeah.
Speed.
No.
Super fast. Flash.
Because if we're living in, like, the world of, like, DC's, like
no, you're
DC.
Living in
no,
your
he said
world.
Help your life.
Your life.
Right now.
I'm saying that, like, with, like, the speedster powers, so that means, like, I'm constantly burning calories and everything, and I'm going
to
be fit because...
Yeah, you need to eat
all the time.
You need to eat or you're going to die.
You die really quick, too.
You have to have the right
yeah,
food, like
sick.
Flash did. You'd have to create that stuff.
Like, 30 pizzas a day. Not even
how
a day. At lunch.
That?
Yeah. You need AA to make those pizzas.
Non-stop.
Non-stop.
Alright.
Hey, I'm not down.
Anybody else? Anybody else? Superpower.
Photographic
memory. Photographic memory would be what would help her
the
most.
That's good. If she wouldn't forget stuff, that's amazing.
Yes.
That would have helped me cheat so many math tests.
School right now,
I got
you. Remembering proper dosages. I wouldn't have to continue checking charts and stuff. I could just look at it once and just know everything I need to know.
You also, the weakness is right there that you have to remember everything.
Right?
Technically,
even if we don't want to.
Okay, technically, you do remember everything. Your brain just doesn't ever give it to you again. You technically don't forget
it. Gives it to
anymore.
You in dreams. As weird
so, I mean,
faces.
Like,
your
shit.
Ability to
so,
recall it
yeah.
is the problem.
Yeah. So instant recall is what you'd want.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
The recallability of, like, a god.
Can we bring that back into the masturbation thing?
Hey, we have a... I'm just saying, though.
No.
We have a pretty savage, like, Justice League so far.
Who else? Who else?
I would
want to
be, like, a shapeshifter.
Shapeshifter.
Yeah.
Like,
little,
more...
That's a good one.
You little sneaky snakes.
Yeah.
We are a
little fucking
team
sneaky
superheroes
snakes.
Right
yeah,
now.
I'm kind of useless, though. I picked a very easy power. Like, I just make money, so, I mean, I guess at that...
You're
like,
funding the entire
you
team.
You know what?
Oh,
can
I just
remember shit.
You got us a jet. You're
it's
getting
true.
You got us a mansion for us to
be our Batman.
What's your
yeah.
power?
Oh my God, I'm a Batman. Oh my God, I'm a Batman. What
yeah.
the fuck? I can't believe I did that.
Yeah,
to
you just made.
I
us...
would make myself. I would buy all the scientists.
Yeah.
In all the world.
You're
to make me all the stuff.
Make gold instead of cash because it's money.
Yeah, dude.
Oh my God. There
wow.
you go.
I made myself Batman.
Yeah.
You'd be like Midas.
Yeah, that'd be crazy. Oh, no, he turned out bad, though. That
no, but
that'd
be essentially what you would be. You'd create gold.
Oh, that's scary.
Anybody else? Anybody else?
Yes.
Superpower? Yes, Chuck?
I would do Darwin's ability. I would adapt.
Adaptability?
Adaptability to everything.
No. Darwin's ability.
Yeah.
But he didn't adapt. He died.
No, so that's just
that's
one comic
shitty movie.
With
a problem.
Kevin Bacon.
You want
Sebastian.
The ability of it? Wait, you want the ability of his turtles and his fishes?
He could do whatever it is he needed to do to get out of any scenario. If he was in water, he'd grow gills. If he was in the air, he would
I
get
like
wings.
That. I like that a lot.
It, you know, you could just adapt.
And I like
that's
that a
awesome. Lot.
So, like, if you didn't have a penis but you wanted to masturbate.
I would adapt some way of doing it.
I mean, sorry, masturbate with a penis.
So if you were trying to masturbate, you could just...
Oh, easily. Or some other means of masturbating.
So, okay, so like if we threw you into space, you could just learn how to breathe the low atmosphere of space.
I would adapt a helmet on my face.
There.
That would have an oxygen.
He would
like,
actually
adapt
a helmet. Wow.
He would actually adapt. No, hold on.
Exactly.
I have a theory. He would actually adapt to not needing to breathe anything. Because
like
you're in the vacuum of space.
Oh. Functionality of self-lung
yeah.
circulation?
Yeah.
Wow. That's fucking creepy.
Isn't that terrifying?
I love it. I love the Darwin one. That's great.
Well, I guess...
Salt, did you have a... Salt, Butts, who else?
He said
did
teleport.
It was teleportation.
Yeah, I think everybody...
Teleportation, that's right.
I can also help with the one you
Can we go through
too.
Our super team and remind everyone what... How bad...
So, Salt is teleportation. We have our Speedster and Snacks. We have Insta-Recall of all facts.
We have our Historian.
For Peaches...
Oh my god, think of all the villain battle plans
like
she could remember if she watched them and then tell them.
No, what was your answer? I'm sorry.
Just have anything I wanted.
Oh, to have anything you wanted disappear. That's right, and then Rue, you have shape shifting. Double A, you have your Batman.
I'm Batman.
You're just gonna have money up here, so that way you can build yourself your suit and everything like that.
It just wouldn't be a bat. I don't know what I'd be, but I just, you know, like I'm Batman.
Chuck Dante is
Iron Man would be tough.
Instant adaptability to any circumstance.
What about you, Surfer Dan?
I want learning osmosis. I want to be able to touch a book and gain all the knowledge from that book.
That was a movie.
And the it was also an X-Men character.
Ooh.
Yes.
But I also
Meteor Man.
Is that what it was?
Yes.
I never saw that movie.
Oh my god.
But I like the idea of being able to, like, instantly, if I want to learn another language, I can just touch the dictionary of that language and just learn all that. Because I would love to see if that would stretch to, like, the internet. If I just touched a computer that was connected, could I just gain all the knowledge? And what I could do with that?
Yeah, just lick your cat cable.
It's Server Dan. I think that's how your head explodes.
But like the idea of, oh shit, I need to repair this Jeep really fast. Here's the manual of the Jeep. I can repair it.
I know Kung Fu.
Not speed reading, literally downloading the information.
Like download your information.
Oh, yeah. Baby.
Like Johnny Mnemonic. More like Johnny Mnemonic. But yeah, we're going there.
I know Kung Fu. Especially if you have access to all the internet.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah. That's my superpower.
It sounds like we have a pretty badass team for all of our spam that's
hell
listening.
Yeah.
You guys should send us possible team names.
Ooh, yes.
Yeah, what's the 42 Strains, the High Justice League?
High and Mighty.
The High Society.
The High and Mighty. The High Society.
I like the High Society.
The Stone Supers.
The Stone Supers. I love it. Did you have any more wacky news stories?
Oh, I do.
What's another wacky news story? I don't even know what time
we're at. I'm not kidding, guys. I didn't do this on purpose. But another world record is broken.
Whoa. I think you
did
this on purpose.
By nickname, Granny Hulk. Who is
I thought Granny Hulk was Helen Mirren.
Wow.
Oh no, I've got a thing for Helen.
Okay.
And now I'm picturing her green and I can't stand. Sorry.
You weren't standing anyway.
Oh.
An Arkansas woman known as Granny Hulk broke a world record deadlifting just 3 months shy of her 70th birthday.
Jeez.
She deadlifted 305 pounds.
Wow.
That's
wow.
How old?
So hold on.
She's
so
3 months before she turned 70.
Let me put that into a perspective.
Oh, and she's only 123 pounds herself.
I think.
Holy shit.
How old is she?
3 months before she was 70.
Wow.
Jesus. So 69.
I think 309 pounds would be Rue, Salt,
go ahead.
Snacks,
go ahead.
And Peach's boobs.
No, go ahead.
Peach's boobs.
Go ahead.
How old is she?
3 months before she was 70, Peach's.
Wait, how old?
Oh, my God.
3 months before she was 70 years old.
Kid.
Wait, but how old was she?
God, we're assholes.
Exactly 3 months before she was
70
years old.
Exactly 3 months.
Someone just turned off the episode they were listening to.
No. If they went through Chuck Dante's coughing fit, if they went through all of the weirdness with everything else, they're not turning off just for the repetition of 3 months before.
How old was she, though?
It was
3 months before
70.
3 months before 75.
Right now, somebody's taking a hit going, 3 months before 70!
Wait, when was her birthday going to be?
3 months from now.
Oh.
Yes, because this is from like 4 days ago.
Yeah.
It was for her 70th birthday.
Yeah, 75th.
Wait, what? You can't change things
she
like that.
I thought it was 75th.
No.
Was
it 70th?
How old was she?
I thought it was 3 months before her 73rd birthday.
3 months before her 70th birthday.
70th. Excuse me, I'm sorry.
Somebody turned us off right now.
No, Jeannie offered me immortality, but I'm losing my hearing anyway.
Oh my god!
She's 69, ladies and gents.
Hot.
Boys and girls.
That's all that matters.
That's all that really matters.
Hold on, that's only so erect my dick can get.
My dick hurts. And she's having a good year.
She's having a
good year. And by the way, she started weightlifting at the age of 60 to offset osteoporosis.
Wow.
This woman is my idol. Hey, if you're out there, find me.
She's from Arkansas.
Wow. You know, some other people that listen might take that a little bit more
literally. Yeah, if you're out there,
ooh.
I'm talking about...
They're just going to peek at your Twitter extra hard and be like,
oh, well, on Stoner Podcast, issues challenge for
issues challenge.
If you're out there, find me. Jesus. Dot, dot,
ooh,
dot.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Wow.
I do have money.
That is impressive. I'm slightly confused and a little aroused.
At the same time?
What the hell, Peaches?
Confused erections?
Yes.
The ones that curve the wrong way.
Those are the best ones.
Wait, are they?
No.
I feel like they're not.
They're not the worst ones.
Man.
It's like a surprise boner. Like, hey, where did this come from?
Yeah, I remember when that happened my sophomore year of high school in the middle of Woodshop, and I didn't want it to happen, so I disagree with your statements.
Yeah, okay. I had those a lot in high school.
I only named one instance. I didn't want to just start listing.
Boners happened a lot.
3 months before
really fucking old.
69!
Can we associate boners with the 60s? Well, I guess.
Why not, you ageist? What the fuck is wrong with you? You don't hate on our old person sexuality? What is wrong with you?
Not my fault.
Not my. There it is. Golden salt. Golden.
She can lift you all day long.
Salt is not a
dude.
That's
just gonna get you going.
But guess what? Cougars are into salt.
I mean, unless she's nice.
She's a gilf.
She is. Unless she seems nice.
She has a good personality.
Honestly, I just wouldn't I'd fuck with a woman who could deadlift 305 pounds. I wouldn't fuck with her. You know what I mean? I'd be like, yeah, I'm on your side.
Oh,
Granny,
okay.
Like, don't worry. I do not oppose you.
Yeah, but can she do?
She's only 123 pounds. She's not that big.
Can she do the Black Widow thigh around the face? Whip you around?
Oh, like a hurricane.
I hope not. That'd be awesome.
I mean, I don't know. Is the answer to that for me? I do not know.
She must wear very active Depends.
Oh!
Well, that depends.
Why would she? She's past what menopause would be, so like.
Depends?
Depends if you're incontinent.
That's just for when you can't hold.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, this whole time you thought they were prepared.
I just thought maybe it was a brand of,
Oh, no, no, yeah. Depends if it's an old people diaper.
It's an old people diaper.
Dude, she can deadlift 305 pounds. She don't need no diaper.
No,
bro.
She needs
She pulled the shield even more. She goes,
Yep.
Jeez.
I love you.
Explosive booty.
Oh my goodness.
All right. We are now very much officially past our 42-minute mark.
And oh, shit.
I have to get up early for bed, so I'm going to...
Bye, Ruth.
You're going to duck out, Ruth? I had one more question. That was it.
Okay.
But do you have any more stories?
I do.
Oh, okay. Do you want? So let's say our goodnights to Ruth. Good night. Cool. Love you. Thank you for joining us on this weird, fun Friday, freely Friday. What is, do we, story or question? Which one do we want first?
Question.
Question?
Yeah, question.
Okay, so if you were going to exist, you, as you, who you are, exist in a cartoon world, what cartoon world do you pick you to suddenly get dropped into as a character?
Cartoon, does it have to be drawn?
Can
it be like computer animation?
It can be computer animation. Puppets. Animated. Not live action animated, like puppets, marionettes, that kind of thing.
Got this.
Animation, whether it be traditionally drawn or computer animation. Animation can be movie or TV show.
Ooh.
Computer could be movie or TV show.
Wow. That's
heavy metal?
That's titties
everywhere.
So you're like half robot.
Yep.
That's all right, savage. Fair enough. I hope it's the upper half.
I hope it's the lower.
Oh, well. Impressive. Anybody else?
Scooby-Doo.
Scooby-Doo.
That's cool.
You'd fit in.
Yep.
You'd be fine. You'd, oh, yeah, you'd be okay. Yeah, you'd be okay.
Yeah, you'd have to kill Shaggy, though.
Snacks, Peaches.
I'm still thinking.
Nobody would even notice.
Right, you just take
Avatar, Last Airbender.
Avatar, the Last Airbender.
I'm a bender, bitches. I'm gonna bend.
I was almost with you.
Come on. Oh, who easy.
Who Framed Roger Rabbit post-dip storyline.
That was, like, my first thought.
Post-dip storyline.
So I don't have to deal with the evil.
Yes.
I just get to live in that world.
So what happens at the end of the movie when they all go in, back into Toontown?
Yeah.
Awesome. Impressive. Impressive. I like... No, that's Cool World. Different movie. Wow. I like that. Am I the only one that has an answer?
No. Snacks. Guys are still thinking.
The only one that's coming to mind right now, it's a tie.
Mm-hmm. The only one that's coming to me right now
is
a tie. I love you, Snacks.
What
I
meant
love
to
you.
Say is that
I,
like, the only
I don't
like,
care what you meant
was,
to
like,
say.
Disney.
We know what
like,
you
I'm
said.
I'm thinking, like, my mind instantly went to, like, Disney films.
That's fine.
So it's a tie between, like, Princess and the Frog, like, Cartoon World, and, like, New Orleans and everything.
Gotcha.
Or, computer animated, like, Tangled. I like, that'd be cool, I think.
Okay. I like
you
that.
You can't pick one, though.
Can't pick one of those?
I think
you can't flip a coin? In your head?
Ooh, Moana.
I think Princess and the Frog.
Princess and the Frog?
Yeah.
Better music.
Yeah, better music.
Better music.
Pretty colors.
Gotcha. I understand
good
that.
Good food.
Good food.
Real good food. Real good food. A lot of fun. I could see that.
Yes.
Plus,
I think be a
Gators know how to play trumpets.
Yeah.
I mean, that's awesome.
We're winning.
But we're winning in that one. I like
in
that
situation.
Moana. I just want to hang out with Hey Hey.
Moana? Fair enough.
I love
Fair
it.
Enough.
I got Buzz Hey Hey for Christmas.
He screams.
Yeah.
It's amazing. It's right over top of my bed.
So when you walk into their house, Hey Hey's just staring at you waiting.
Yep.
Fair enough. Salt, did you answer? Sorry.
Yeah, mine was...
His was Scooby-Doo.
Scooby-Doo, that's right, because you were going to be Shaggy.
What are you going to say that? The rest of us just assumed.
It's true. I was torn between two different worlds, and it was going to be Hanna-Barbera, or it was going to be Looney Tunes. However, and I say Hanna-Barbera or Looney Tunes because... All of their cartoons existed in the same world. Hanna-Barbera, Flintstones, and Jetsons exist in the same world. So if I pick Flintstones, I already exist with Huckleberry Hound, Yogi Bear, all of them. Specifically, if you asked, I'd be part of Wacky Races, so that way I could join in on everybody's fun.
That's awesome.
The other one I was torn with was Looney Tunes, but humans don't fare well in Looney Tunes. So if I show up as
fine.
Me in Looney Tunes... Yes, but I mean, if I show up as a toon human, Elmer Fudd, Yosemite Sam, I wouldn't fare well in Looney Tunes.
Yeah.
But in Hanna-Barbera, even though the animals like Yogi Bear gives Ranger Dave a bad time, he still doesn't like actively try to hurt him. So I'm going to go with the Hanna-Barbera cartoons.
Yeah,
I'd be
anyway, so
which means I get to hang out with Salt because Scooby-Doo was in Hanna-Barbera.
Oh, right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Nice.
So that's where I'd go.
Got one?
I don't know.
You don't even have, like, ones you're, like, thinking in between?
The Lion King and save Mufasa.
You can't save him. It'll change too many things.
Yeah.
I'd eat you.
If you have to be...
Oh, hot.
Yeah.
That would not be good.
Not really.
You're gonna be you. You're not gonna be an animal version of you. Just remember that.
No.
So you don't get dropped
that's
in.
That's why she's saying
say,
no, Lion King.
Yeah.
Because she'll die.
Yeah, very quickly. Very
by
quickly.
Something. Pretty much everything.
You see the land? You see that big-breasted, beautiful woman over there? She's your lunch.
And that is
save
ours.
The titties for your papa.
Oh, God.
They're the meatiest.
They're my favorites. They pop in my mouth like bonbons. I don't know why I made Ron Burgundy Mufasa all of a sudden.
Do you think lions have specific parts of animals they like
Simba.
More than others?
Simba.
Probably.
Yeah. They're like,
Simba, look at the
throat.
Lion here. Look at the lion.
Yeah, right?
It's
yeah, like, you know, like
a big
throat.
Land.
Just like
the
rest of us, ass first.
Big, long land. It's named San Diego.
I mean, that might be a possibility. Maybe, you know, if Wilfred taught me anything, is the asshole is the first place you start.
That's where you should start eating.
Yeah, honestly.
All right, do you have any more stories?
Speaking of Wilfred the dog.
Yes.
A dog was found swimming 136 miles from the shore of a beach.
Jesus.
In the ocean.
What?
Yeah, think about how far that is.
I can barely swim 10 feet out before I'm dying.
I don't know.
Not mine.
But it was like...
Definitely not ours.
It was found basically at the base of like an oil rigger that's in the middle of the ocean, you know? And
Did it fall off?
No, like it this wasn't oil rig, this guy just
so it wasn't even dug. Somebody's on the oil rig. It just they randomly found it.
Yeah, they want to like the person who found it wants to adopt it because like they have no fucking.
They food. Earned it.
Yeah. I'd like to believe that this dog was like on some type of floating piece of something,
boat, right?
Like yeah. Or a floating like scrap for a while, and then that got compromised, and he got found.
Has anybody gone through the list of missing boats and see if any of them had a dog on them?
I don't think so because it just said the last thing.
I think we could connect this to a missing case.
I think the article that leaves off on.
Or the Bermuda Triangle is starting to send us canines.
Oh, I like that.
Which is fine. I'm okay with this. As far as interdimensional trade, we'll trade Amelia Earhart for a good puppy.
Yeah.
What a good boy. What a good doggo.
And all it was is they spotted him in the water under the rig and just you got something to yank him up.
Wow.
That's awesome.
You know, they probably already had, like, tools to get people out of water, yeah, so they could probably
get
a dog out of
water. You would hope that people working on a royal rig would have...
No, they figure what you pull in, you know.
It's just, there it is. We told you. The
we told you to be careful.
There's probably signs everywhere.
Look, there. You knew...
Over
yeah,
the edge is
your
last chance.
It's
like, that's
you
it.
You signed a contract.
Exactly.
Said your family can't sue us.
Man, we made working on an oil rigger pretty bad very quickly.
Fair. Well, I'm assuming it's not a joy.
They get paid a lot of money.
Yeah, and they also sometimes drill into asteroids. I know, I've seen the movie.
I love it.
Wow.
What?
Oh, God, yeah.
A Paris marathon runner broke the record for running this certain
with the
marathon.
Most shirts. We already
no,
talked about
no, no. This time it was in high heels.
Oh, my goodness!
She
broke a world record for running a marathon. She ran a marathon in high heels when she finished the Paris Marathon with a time of 6 hours, 4 minutes, and 7 seconds.
That bitch is crazy.
26.2 miles.
Wow.
Wow.
Woo!
Ow. Yes.
Because it's to run from one
from
marathon to
what
run.
What kind
yes.
of heels? Because that really makes a difference.
Hi.
Yeah, but are we talking like
you couldn't
do
it.
Are we talking like 2 inches?
No.
Are we talking like 6-inch heels?
No.
Don't
heels.
Look at me like that.
It doesn't
you
matter.
Do it in Skechers.
It doesn't
so
matter.
I don't know
it's not chunky
impressed.
Heels.
It's not wrong. I am very
it's
impressed,
not
but
stilettos.
I just want to know what kind of heels.
Standard heels.
It doesn't say how big the heels are, but the reason she did it was because a friend challenged her to do so because she saw her run in her heels to like through the rain one time. So I imagine she was just wearing some like nice heels and then like ran in them, and a friend was like, "Yeah, that'd be funny if you ran a
marathon."
Run a marathon
in it,
and she did.
Why?
So I assume they're not.
Why?
I just because and there was already a record of 7 hours, 27 minutes, and 53 seconds,
no.
and she fucking crushed that.
No.
By like over an hour.
I'm just
crushed
wondering
that.
If she broke her.
I just
want to
know how her feet are doing.
Probably bad.
Is she okay?
She has no toes left.
She trained in them too.
They,
she actually like trained for the
just
marathon.
She
she'd run in
off,
her regular shoes during
off.
The
they
day, but
off.
Then at night time she would switch to the heels so that way she just
they
didn't get pictures taken of her.
Going to market and I'm taking all these motherfuckers.
Such a high risk of like
fuck this
rolling and spraining your ankle.
If anybody is listening carefully to this podcast and hearing both stories going on at the exact same time, they both had good information and funny. I'm just saying.
We bring you a lot, guys.
Sometimes on top of each other.
Yeah, seriously.
Yeah.
Sometimes we're here for the masses. That's all the stories that I have for this 420.
Which is good because it's about time that we should probably wrap this bitch up.
I mean,
I wrap it
yeah.
up nightly.
We.
I don't wrap it.
We said this was a free form, free falling free love, free balling, clusterfuck of an episode, and I loved every second of it.
Me too.
We smoked so much weed, and
we
it is.
We did.
It's like a really nice period of like study hall back in high school.
Yeah, it was like, hey, what do you want to talk about? It was fun. Did you ever get an answer in Cartoon World that you'd like to live in, Peaches?
No, she stopped
Then we're just
going to
assign you one.
It.
We're going to just give you a Cartoon World. Anybody want to give one?
Yeah, I think I got one for.
Yeah.
I think I'm. Gonna put
I'm putting
Peaches.
A Pokemon, just go and catch a little ball.
You know, Pokemon's a good one. That was actually up there for me.
You can't catch
No, she's a person.
Ball.
They don't
like
catch people
person.
in the Pokeballs.
She's small. She'd go in a ball.
No, it literally works with only the Pokemon.
Listen, this is my world, and
I'm sorry. Saul, do you
no,
hear this blasphemous information coming from this guy?
Where are you putting Peaches?
Looks like a person.
I don't know now. I'm completely thrown off by this ball conversation that doesn't...
All right, say goodnight, Alice.
Until next time...
Stay high!
Stay golden.
And smoke with you soon. Just wanna be making noise. You wanna hit, it's your choice. But please enjoy the show. I didn't smoke no grass today. But that's cause I'm the one on stage. So who am I to take away what makes you feel this great?